That's scary. Hello guys, and welcome back to the public server of the Dinosaur mod. This is going to be episode 10, and it's going to be, I think, just a short update video, just to keep, you know, get you guys up to speed about what's been happening, since I haven't made a video in quite a while, and things really have been progressing. A little bit more than what I can handle right now, in terms of knowing what's happening in all places at once. Because in the beginning, when it was just Anger and I and Toady, and then Ginger came along and Shenanigans, we were a few, you know, and I knew it was happening in all areas of the server, or at least our little corner of the server here. But now things are really progressing. We've got, I think, 21 members, including King. Hello, King. I don't think he knows that I'm recording. Yeah, he seems to be AFK as well. But okay, yeah, that's a very cool skin. I really like that. A Nightmare Before Christmas. Still haven't seen that. Anyway, yeah, so things are really, really progressing, and there are things on the server that I haven't seen, probably, since yesterday. And other things that I saw yesterday that I hadn't seen, and I thought I'd just show it all off today. So let me start here, something that we did quite soon after the last episode. We put up these pillars here. Now, these pillars represent Bam Bam and Pebbles, and they've got the names of all the members that are on them, or in them. Even Frank and Barry, the two Nautilus. So, yeah, unfortunately, as much as we've gained a lot of new members... Hey, Creeper, don't you dare, I saw you. I saw it. No. That's okay, the server's protected anyway. Ah, King is alive. Hello, King. So yeah, as much as we've gained a lot of members, we've also sort of, you know, we've gained members that joined once and didn't log on, like the legendary Shirts Green. Shirts Green is a guy that joined and we just never saw him again. He was here once. And then we've gotten some others. I'm not going to say who, because they might pick up interest again. I hope they do. But there are some that seem to have lost interest. And so yeah, I'm trying to balance the teams so that each team has got a fair and sort of equal amount of active members. Which is why Frank and Barry up there, even though, yeah, they're not human, the teams are indeed equal. And as for the dinosaur parks, they are being built, don't you guys worry. I will show you guys that in the next episode, probably. Team Bam Bam has progressed more than Team Pebbles, and so we'll probably show off their park first, or at least how far they've come. So yes, anyway, let me go now. I've decided I'm going to take a walk around and show you guys all the new stuff. And my little project, my most recent project, is this here, our pathway. Thank you to Dark for giving me the material, the ancient stone and ancient stone bricks. And yes, here we go. Yeah, of course I will get stragglers, passers-by, dangerous passers-by. Passerbyers? What's the plural of passerby? Anyway, so yeah, here's the pathway. And, oh, well, here's a Dilophosaurus I didn't even know about. Hello, you. Let's take a closer look here. Hey, who do you belong to? Do I have my dino? Yes, yes, good. Let's check who owns this Dilophosaurus. Probably Anger, since this is his house. Yes, indeed. James has got a Dilophosaurus, and he seems to be... ooh, not very healthy, but full up on hunger, so that's good. Just don't go getting stuck in a wall. Poor dinosaurs are known to do that. Getting themselves stuck in walls. So yes, this is the format of the pathway. I think it looks very pretty. The checkered look like this with the grass and the ancient stone, and then any side pathways that lead off to houses use gravel so that they don't get sort of lost with the rest of the grass. Now let me run along here. Let me go this way around because there are new things. Oh, there! That's my pterosaur perch. Unfortunately, my pterosaur died, just like my velociraptor also died. Unfortunately, yeah, they don't seem to have a very long lifespan. It's because here on the server, even if you log off, of course, they continue living. So it's hard to keep them alive. It seems that the feeders are glitched. The dinosaurs only use the feeders when they feel like it. So yeah. Okay, so here we go. Here's the pathway. That was the randomizer episode. We still use this sometimes to randomize new members into the teams. And okay, so let's continue this way. Go through here. The village is on this side, and the ship. I wonder, has that been shown off? I don't think so. Let me get over there quickly. Here we go. This was mainly Ginger's project and shenanigans, and I'm sure other people helped as well. We've got a nice little village here. Although I don't see the villagers. What has happened to the villagers? Oh, here they all are. They're having a community gathering, it seems. Children are allowed. Look at that. This one really looks like a little Boy Scout. Anybody who's a Paul Suarez Jr. fan will know Bub, the cookie-selling Boy Scout. Anyway, okay, so that's our villagers and the ship that they built. I think it's a really nice, cute little ship. And so that's this part of the world. Oh, and here's the villager pig. Hello. I thought you died. Maybe you're a new one. Anyway, okay, let me get back to the pathway. And the sun is coming up. Beautiful. Okay, so here's the tunnel I came through, and then here we go this way. The pathway continues. Oh, here's a path that I didn't know about. What is this? Somebody's house? Here's a sign, let's see here. Help yourself, but please replant. Shirt. Ah, this is shirt. This is shirt screen. You see, he came, he saw, he built, and he left, and he never came back. See, Merry Christmas from Shenanigans. There's all these presents still for Christmas time. And from Toady. Yeah, Toady gave us the most wonderful gifts. Thank you, Toady, for giving us all these awesome, diamonds and emeralds. Very valuable things, usually. And, okay, so that was that one. Here's another side pathway. Oh, this goes to Shenanigans' place over there. The beautiful, very beautiful house. I really like Shenanigans' house. Overlooking the witch hut and the bay. And Shirtscreen's house. Okay, so now let's get back. And we'll go this way. Now, we do have new members, and when I get to their house, I don't know if they're home, I'll check, I'll knock on the door. This here is the original Cam's place, who hasn't been on in a long time. And then we do have a new member who's close by, the one that joined yesterday. Let me see here. Is he around? Let's see. I know he doesn't have TeamSpeak, so he won't be able to be interviewed. But I guess I could just show you his house. Okay, I'm back on the pathway. I went looking for the new guy's house. His name is Ernesto, but it seems he hasn't really done much on it, so I'm not going to waste too much time on that. Then let's go this way. I love this pathway through the trees. My house is, of course, there somewhere deep in the trees. And then here's a pathway to the shrine. And actually, that's the way I should go now. Go this way, go past the shrine here. Let's just hold to fix that later. And I'll cross the shrine. I see that our plesiosaur has been damaged. I'll fix that too later. And here we go. Here are three new beautiful places to show off. That there, I believe, is Cam's house, Cam Tom, the second Cam. And it really looks nice. Look at that. Beautiful. Grand edifices coming out of the ocean. Pretty. Then over here, I mean, there's one new member that I would like to introduce. Let me just get back to the pathway. So he built his house here, pretty close by. Let me see here. Yeah, there it is. And it's a very nice house, very cozy. And we're getting round again to our sacred bonsai. The pathway goes all the way around everything. And here we have the House of Edward. Now, Edward is our second newest member. Let me see if he's here. Let me see if he's home. Knock, knock. Edward? Yeah, okay, so he's not home. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look up into the sky and wait for time to pass. And yeah, then maybe he'll be home at night time. He's probably out doing errands. Ah, much better. It's night time now. Man, I can't believe I stood here for this long. My neck, it hurts. Ow. So let's see if Edward's home. Ooh, what? Okay, what? Who the hell are you? Hey, come back here. Freaky. Okay, anyway. So, let's see here. Edward? Knock, knock.
Come in.
Ah, you're home. Hello, Edward. Hey. I was here earlier, and you were out doing errands or something. Oh, there he is again. Did you know Santa exists? I just saw him. Not even kidding.
What is it?
I don't know. He was like right here by your window. Anyway, so say hello to the viewers and introduce yourself, Edward, our second newest member. He was there, I swear.
I see him. But anyway, what's up?
Yeah.
I'm Edward.
Oh, I think you've got a problem there with your cultivator.
When that
there we go, much better. Okay, so shall we sit, have tea?
Sure, I have tea.
How do we do this? Not that much sugar, hold on. Oh, there he is again! Freaky.
Kill it.
Hold on a second, I'm trying to sit. I'll take this stuff later. Ah, much better. I love it that we can sit here. Yeah. Thank you. I should pick that up. There we go. So, introduce yourself, Edward, now that we are here seated. I still haven't got my tea, but it looks suspiciously like chicken soup, so that's okay. Chicken essence. So, yeah, tell us, who are you, Edward, and how did you first get into Minecraft?
Well, how I first got into Minecraft was one day I have this friend of mine named Henry, and so we would usually play a whole bunch of games. It all started from like Adventure Quest Worlds, and then one day he asked his father could he have Minecraft. So I was like, wow, that game's boring. It looked kind of boring. So then one day I came to his house and we were playing on land, on a land world, me, him, and his brother, and I just got attached to it.
Alright. I'm just looking at myself here. I look really snazzy sitting down like this. Okay. Yeah, I guess that's many a person's story. At first you think, what kind of game is this? It's all blocky and old-looking. But yeah. Okay, and what's your favorite thing about Minecraft, would you say, right now?
My favorite thing about Minecraft would probably be the fact that you can meet unique people and play with them.
Yeah, actually, I'd never thought of that point. Yeah, it has brought many like-minded people together. Indeed. So, yeah, like us, right? Everybody here who likes the dinosaurs. So, okay. Thank you for that. I like your house. And unfortunately, I couldn't drink the tea, but I'll try and eat the sugar. Oh, okay, it's not working. I'll use it in a cake recipe later. I see you've put it to good use. So, yeah. Thanks, Edward. And say goodbye to everybody. Do you know what team you're on?
Pebbles.
Pebbles. That's right, everybody. He's on Pebbles' team. Bye, Santa.
Goodbye.
Yeah, that is, everybody, is Bleeder, actually, Dylan. He's got a new, or I think it's his old skin, but he's got a new name. So there we go. But okay, let me look up into the sky again. There we go. That worked. So, let's continue on this way. You all met Edward. Hope you liked him. And now I don't know what we're going to do. Oh, no. Now we're going to go over to Zam's place and we're going to watch the birthing of his Triceratops. So let me just get to his place. I'll be right back. So guys, I'm here with my friends Shenanigans, King, and Zam. Hello guys.
Hello.
And what did you have in your hand there, Zam? Yes, indeed. Look at that.
That is a Triceratops egg.
Triceratops egg. So that's what we're going to be doing now. We're going to be witnessing the birth of your new Triceratops. So, lead the way. This is Zam's house, by the way. He adopted the style that I like, being sort of hidden in the
forest.
Yeah,
I'm actually working on a redstone secret entrance door, but I ran out of redstone.
Oh, this
is
really awesome.
Well, I have plenty of redstone if you need it.
Not enough ferns here.
No, there needs to be more.
I agree.
I love this. I love how it sort of comes up above one block.
Alright.
<Ooh. laughs> That's scary.
Kind of disappear.
Okay, so
here my Triceratops is going to be spoiled.
Whoa, diamond block. How did the diamond block just appear here?
Diamond blocks everywhere.
Yeah, when you put stuff on ferns, they magically appear above the ferns.
Right. Okay.
So it's going to be a spoiled Triceratops.
Oh, you're going to hatch him in here, are you? Ah, very nice.
Yeah, they eat ferns, so.
Okay, so there's the egg. Doesn't it need a torch? There we go. So I guess you can do the countdown, and I'll skip the video ahead to before he hatches.
6, 7, 8, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Aww,
oh, yeah.
Oh, so cute.
Where is he? Guy. He's so small, he like, gets lost in the... Where'd he go?
He's running around the ferns.
Hello.
Do I have to do something pretty special thing. To tame him, or is that just because I was close? Or...
Check your Dinopedia.
Yeah,
Should say your name in it now with the Triceratops.
Yep, well, Cam's the owner.
Yep.
That's it.
Very cool. Nice.
Very cute.
And
is he well fed?
Will go hungry. Yeah, I don't think he'll go hungry anytime soon.
Yeah.
No, indeed not.
No, not possible.
All right, so that's awesome. Now the next thing I wanted to do, just to finish off the video, was to show off your place, King, because I decided to edit out the part that I recorded now while I was going around, because you're on, so you can show it off much better than
that's
I can.
Be.
So let's go.
Alrighty then.
Everybody coming with? Alright, and so we are approaching...
This is my nether wart farm.
I was wondering about that last night. Ooh, and
there it is,
indeed.
The holiday stump.
When I saw this, I was like, oh my gosh, that's awesome. Yesterday, online. That really is nice.
I gotta push the button, because the button's over here. Ah, come here.
Oh right, and it opens. Woo! That is awesome.
Now everybody inside, and don't step on the pressure plate just yet, because otherwise it'll close.
If I were a troll.
Very nice.
And watch out for the fall, it's a juicy!
Woohoo! Oh! Man.
Fall beaten.
Lucky for that water.
Yep. That fall
or the ender pearl.
Nice.
This is really cool.
Welcome to the inside chamber of my house.
The underground lair of King Metallus. Or Jack.
Yep. Over here is the mine. I still got a lot of materials to mine out of there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Lots of iron. Over this way, still under construction, of course, but over here is going to be my lab, as well as my storage area and my farm.
Here's the farm down here. Will your lab be evil?
I'm thinking about it. It'll have potions, and I'll be making a lot of dastardly potions.
Ooh. Okay.
Still under construction.
Indeed.
However, my potion room has lava with it, so I'm very excited.
Okay, so you seem to have it all planned out. And what about that other direction?
The other direction. That, of course, is the bedroom.
Aha. And this part is part of the faction, apparently. I claimed it.
Yep. And I can only sleep at night.
Very cozy. Very cozy.
Now, as for how you're going to get out, you guys are going to have to get out.
Well, I guess I'm going to have to teleport out because I have no other way.
Well, the only way out now is to wake up from your nightmare.
Like I just did?
Yep.
How did you wake up from your nightmare, Zan?
Ender pearls.
Ah, yes, indeed.
Lots and lots of ender pearls.
Do I have any on me? Oh, no. Okay, so, you know what? I'm going to end
there. You can stand in the netherrack.
Stand in the netherrack?
There's lots of netherrack in my room.
What will happen if I stand in the netherrack? Oh! Ow!
You'll burn.
Except that... What? I'm not losing any hearts. Why?
Well, that's interesting.
That's odd. You should be.
Bone armor.
That helps.
Oh man, bone armor is so overpowered.
It is extremely overpowered.
Your fire does not harm me. What?
Curses.
Okay, so I think I'll end the episode with me on fire. No, wait, I like that. Ow, ow, ow. Oh, now I'm losing hearts. No! No!
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Well, at least it's one way to get out of here, right? Ooh, nice and warm and toasty. Oh, now I'm not losing hearts. Now I'm gaining hearts. Why?
I don't know.
Oh, I see.
I know for a fact that if I were to jump in there, I would definitely lose all my hearts.
Yeah, no, it's got something to do with standing in the fire. Watch, I'm gonna get out of your place now. I'm gonna wake up from my nightmare.
You're going to wake up.
Indeed. And I'm waking up. Bye-bye. And I'm awake. Whoa, where am I? Oh, here. Everything is green. Oh no, still on fire! Oh, still on fire. Okay, anyway. No, not on fire anymore. So, I'm going to end the episode here. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for participating. And shenanigans, I guess the next episode, you and some of your team members will go with me and we'll check out your park.
Sounds like a plan. You've got a decent start.
Yeah. Yeah, since you guys are a bit more ahead than the other team. So, yes, okay, thank you guys for watching the video. Give me a like, as usual, it helps my channel a lot. Excuse you. And, yeah, bye-bye. Alright, guys, so it's another clip which I don't know where I'm going to put in the video, because Dylan, or at least Mad Miner...
Hello.
Who you will meet now, or who you may have met already, depending on where I've put this video. He wants to hatch his Pachycephalosaurus, and we're going to get it on camera. So here's his secret little entrance to the Pachy. And, yeah, okay, I can get through here, good. So, hey, wait a second, I feel like an ambush. Oh!
Dun, hello. Dun, dun!
So, the whole gang's here.
We were waiting.
Or not the whole gang, but some of the gang. It's nice to have James on camera again. He hasn't been on for a while.
Howdy, howdy.
So, let's do it, you really creepy-looking center person.
Thank you.
Is it okay to
It looks like it's got fire.
Yeah, it looks really cool, actually.
That's okay, I think. Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, good. So, I guess we will come back when just before he hatches, right? He or she.
Yeah.
Hello, Cam Tom.
Hello.
Spotlight's yours for 3 seconds.
What?
The spotlight is yours for 2 seconds now. Oh well, too late. Shenanigans.
Yes.
How does it feel to be close up on camera?
I don't like it.
Oh, shame. What happened there? Oh, and Anger's Anger's hiding. Hey, how did you glitch my mouse like that, Anger? What did you do? Oh, you're holding. Is that a? It couldn't be.
It is.
Dun dun dun.
Wow.
It is.
I'm impressed.
Don't touch shears.
No, that's not what you are holding. Alrighty then, the egg is about to hatch.
Dun, 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 dun.
Oh, and he's. Oh, that's a different color. And he's eating all the flowers. That's so cute. Wow.
Yeah, it's mine. Alright. What am I going to call him?
Was this coloration due to the biome or something? Or
no idea.
Random?
No, apparently.
Oh, yeah, we're going to take a biome.
I think.
That's why, are you?
Is that it? Are you sure? Because.
Yeah,
I've done some testing. Yeah, but I've done some testing in creative with lots of eggs, and at least with the Triceratops, it was random with the colors. Maybe it's not.
Oh, no, that's the Triceratops, because some biomes have certain colors for them.
Okay. So this one's very cute. I hope he lives.
I'm gonna call him. I do too.
I really hope he lives.
What does it look like on your screen, Jody?
Well, he's like white, white and
yeah, that's.
Brown spots.
Oh, okay.
He's white with black spots on it.
Or black, yeah, kind of dark brown. But okay, so that's yeah, that. We've hatched your packy. So, yeah, the video will continue now with wherever I am in the video. Yeah, I like that egg. Oh, thank you. Such a nice gift.
I hit the wrong button.
Dragon egg.
I've got plenty more where that came from.
The beard is all that thing needed.
Slime's called Jerry.
Do you guys want to hear a funny story?
Sure.
Okay. Zan, Cam, Tom, and myself were on last night, and this guy in chat, in general, global chat, asked people if he could get some carrot seeds. Okay, I understand. He said carrot seeds. And somebody says... So somebody goes... Somebody else in chat says, well, you have to get a carrot. You know, there aren't seeds. And I said, you know, it'd be funny. And then I said, if we, like, renamed some seeds to carrot seeds and gave them to him. And Zan says, I have pumpkin seeds. So he goes and he does it. He makes, like, 3 of them up. And he gives them to the guy. And then later on at night, Zan says, well, how'd things go? And the guy says, well, they haven't grown yet. I'm busy doing something. So, like, okay. A little bit later, WTF, these are pumpkins. Zan told him that that these carrot seeds will grow a little bit larger than normal carrots.
Look, it's little Jerry.
Yeah,
we need
awesome.
To give him an item.
The other two Jerrys drowned.
Oh, Jerry.
And that one looks to be now as well.
So, are you guys sure about this? I mean, I'm getting a little bit drowsy.
Don't do it! Jody!
It looks like a comfortable bed.
Did I accept yours, Jesse? Alright, there you are.
Yeah, we're here. Ginger, you sure you don't want one? I got one right here.
I'm sure. Why don't you guys take a nap?
Like, I really want to know what's gonna happen, so, yeah, here we go. Good night, I guess.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Oh! It destroyed
it
blocks!
It does work!
What was that?
What? And it worked! Oh my
thanks!
Gosh.
I was standing
the
above there!
The ultimate griefing device.
We found another way to break blocks.
I think Ginger took more damage than I did.
Yeah. That fell through the fire, through the explosion.
Well, thanks for that, guys.
You're welcome. Some lava here.
Sure.
Oh, wow.
There we go, that's better.